The Duchess of Sussex dazzled in a sweeping kaftan-inspired Dior gown as she joined husband Prince Harry for a reception at the British ambassador's residence in Morocco on Sunday night. Mother-to-be Meghan, 37, looked radiant in the custom crystal-embellished cream number, which she teamed with metallic heels, a favorite pair of £6,950 diamond earrings and a satin clutch, also by Dior. The royal couple, who are on a three-day tour of the North African country, spent the evening mingling with captains of industry, military officers, disabled athletes and young business leaders. Issuing a clarion call to feminists, Meghan told a group of female executives and entrepreneurs that women around the world need to push the boundaries to advance their cause. "Women have to challenge everywhere in the world," she said. The evening event was hosted by British Ambassador Thomas Riley and his wife Leah at their official residence in the capital of Rabat, a city which has been rocked by riots in recent days. The appearance rounded off a busy second day of engagements, which saw Harry, 34, and Meghan travel to the town of Annecy in the foothills of the Atlas Mountains to visit a secondary school and meet pupils. The Duchess, who impressed by speaking in French, also took part in a traditional henna ceremony. The couple appeared in good spirits as they spent time speaking to some 130 influential Moroccans at their reception. The Duchess, who has made women's empowerment a key part of her work, discussed issues facing women with Miriam Bensala, chief executive of finance and agricultural firm the Holmarcom Group, who told her that Moroccan women had made great advances towards equality but still faced disadvantages. "We were discussing how there are still many boundaries all over the world," the business executive said. Harry and Meghan were greeted by the sounds of a five-piece Moroccan band as they arrived at the ambassador's residence hand in hand. The Duchess gown, which featured dramatic cape sleeves and flattering draping, caught the light as they made their way down the red carpet that had been rolled out in their honor. The royal finished the sumptuous look with a satin clutch with a playful bee detail on the clasp and the snowstorm earrings by Canadian jewelry brand Burke's, which she has worn on a number of previous occasions. She wore her hair swept back in a sleek low bun and opted for a smoky eye and bronze makeup that accentuated her natural beauty. The Duke and Duchess were met outside by Mr. Riley's daughters, Orla, 12, and Elsa, 8, who presented the Duchess with two bouquets of flowers picked from the garden. Accepting the first bouquet from Orla, Meghan said, "Thank you, that is so kind, they are beautiful." The Duchess introduced her husband, turning to him saying, "This is Harry," as the Duke bent down to shake the sisters' hands. After asking Elsa her name, Meghan was handed a second bouquet, which she smelt exclaiming, "Wow, they are so sweet." Afterwards, Orly said, "We were quite nervous meeting them but they were really nice. Prince Harry asked us if we lived here all the time or whether this was a temporary house and asked us if we had parties like this every week, which we don't otherwise it would be a lot of work. It's been a lot of preparation but really fun." The flowers we gave them were from our garden which we helped choose and Meghan said they were beautiful which we are so glad about. Elsa said, "It's been very busy but at the end it all turned out well and it was very good." Inside the royal couple were invited to wash their hands in scented rose water in a traditional welcome. Most Moroccan families make their own rose water from steeped rose petals to offer their guests the chance of freshening up when they arrive at their home. At tonight's reception, two embassy workers, Rachida Benaniba and Rachida Juji, poured rose water from ornate sprinklers onto the royal couple's hands and then gave them towels to dry their hands. "Merci," said Meghan. The couple had impressed local school children with her French earlier in the day. The Duke and Duchess were then shown into the house by the ambassador to be welcomed by guests from across Moroccan society including young leaders, entrepreneurs, business representatives and influential people from local girls' education and sport. The event was held to highlight the positive difference the guests have made to Moroccan society through their influence and activities. Earlier, Harry and Meghan visited the town of Annecy to learn about the Moroccan NGO Education for All, AFA, founded by British entrepreneur Michael McHugo as their royal tour of Morocco began in earnest. During their visit on Sunday, Meghan apologized for her high school French, but while her linguistic skills earned her compliments, Harry admitted he doesn't speak the language at all, prompting one girl to remark, she was better than her husband. Meghan, 37, was casually dressed in a £394 Alice plus Olivia blazer and skinny jeans teamed with £90 Birdie slippers and a £67 blanket scarf from Wilfred, a far cry from the dazzling Couture Valentino gown she wore to touchdown in Casablanca last night. She later changed into a smarter look for an investiture ceremony at a second AFAB boarding house, pairing her jeans with the white tunic shirt and black slingback heels. AFAB builds boarding houses for girls aged 12 to 18 to ensure that youngsters from rural communities in the mountain region are able to access secondary education, a cause close to Meghan's heart as an outspoken advocate of women's rights. Students lined the streets in anticipation of the couple's arrival, and Meghan, who is 7 months pregnant, was handed a bunch of roses by 16-year-old student Hasna. During the visit, the Duchess took part in a henna ceremony, an ancient custom that is thought to have its roots in North Africa, and had a design painted on her hand to celebrate her pregnancy. The traditional henna flower was applied by 17-year-old Samira Wadi, who has lived at AFAB for 6 years. At one of six girls' boarding houses for charity Education for All, Meghan sat down with Samir, who painted three delicate flowers on her left hand. Meghan watched intently as Samira quickly drew the design, encouraging Harry to watch and also to take the mentee they were offered. "How lovely," she said. "Merci." Samira said, "It's tradition for pregnant women in Morocco to have a henna tattoo. We do it for major celebrations like getting married or having a baby. It's like the plant of paradise, so we use it to mark all major occasions." After one concerned official asked if she wanted to wash it off immediately, she laughed and said, "It will dry as we walk through." Baby Sussex was quite the theme for the girls, as they sang songs of welcome and good luck for the baby due in April as the couple arrived and left. After the henna ceremony, Harry and Meghan met some of the girls who live in the boarding house and go to school at the Lycée Grand Atlas opposite. Looking at a board containing the girls' biographies, Harry commented to Meghan, "This is very interesting. They always mention the father, my father wanted me to do this, my father that, etc." "Yes, the paternal narrative is very strong," replied his wife, who is a strong supporter of women's rights. In the computer room, Meghan spoke to a number of high school girls, including Saida Ogbo, 18. "First they chatted in English, 'Your English is fantastic,' Meghan told her. 'You do your homework here as well as research? It's your last year of school, do you want to go to university and what do you want to do?' Saida said she wanted to be a writer like her favorite author William Shakespeare. Meghan then started chatting in French to a group of girls, telling them it was nice they could all do their exams together. The teenager said, her French was good and it was a surprise she spoke it so well, but Harry said he didn't speak French at all. She was better than her husband. On a CV from her acting days, Meghan described herself as proficient in French and fluent in Spanish. As Meghan chatted with the girls, one said, in English, "Thank you so much for being here with us." Meghan replied, "It's an honor to be here. I'd love to come back. What's happening here in so many places all over the world with more girls getting an education, it changes the future and changes the future for everyone, not just the girls." Harry and Meghan were then taken upstairs to be shown the girls' dormitory. Around 35 girls live in the house, one of six in any town. The couple were affectionate through the engagement, Harry placing his arm around the back of Meghan's chair in the classroom and holding hands outside. Out of the football pitch, where they watched a mixed-sex team play football, the couple strolled the length of the pitch before stopping to talk with goalkeeper Salima Bazes, 16. Speaking what she later described as all sorts of languages, the couple gestured to her ring finger to ask if she was married or engaged, as well as talking about her football skills, age and name.